Joining me now is CNN military analyst Lieutenant Colonel Rick Francona. Colonel, what are your thoughts on the chaos surrounding the attack on Istanbul that killed 30 police officers?
Yeah, the group that's taking credit for this is the TAK. Now, the Turks believe them to be nothing more than an affiliate of the PKK, the outlawed and designated terrorist group, a Kurdish separatist group. However, we're not sure of the exact connection there, but we do know that they are responsible for a series, a litany of violence against the Turkish government over the past few years. So it's not surprising that they're involved. And the choice of target, you know, a crowded area. But as you said, the target was police officers. And this is a tactic we've seen with the PKK in the past as well. They primarily go after military and police targets rather than the population as a whole. So I think it's just yet another in this series of violence that we're going to see in Turkey.
Yeah, Colonel, we heard Turkish President Erdogan say that he was going to take every measure to exact revenge on this group. What would that look like?
Oh, it's going to be a crackdown, of course, in southern Turkey. But, of course, you know, the Turks are involved in northern Syria. They've got quite a few troops there, armor, artillery, special forces, air power. They're supporting the Free Syrian Army trying to move on the ISIS capital of Raqqa. But while they're there as well, they are also conducting strikes against the Kurds in northern Syria, the Kurds that we are allied with. They're called the YPG. I know these initials get confusing, but the Turks regard all of these Kurds to be either affiliates of or sympathetic Turks, yeah, to the PKK. So we're going to see a lot more Turkish action directed at the Kurds, both in Turkey and northern Syria.
Switching to Egypt now, Colonel, you've spent some time there. You actually met the Egyptian Coptic Pope. Why would someone target them? What could be the motive here?
Well, this has been going on for years. Since the fall of the Mubarak government in 2011, we've seen an uptick in violence directed against the Christians. And this was exacerbated when the democratically elected government of Mohamed Morsi, a member of the Muslim Brotherhood, was removed from power by the current president, Abdel Fattah el-Sisi. And so this violence increased even through that. And when I talked to the Pope last, right after the removal of Morsi, he was very concerned that the violence would no longer be directed against the Egyptian government, but against the Christians, because the Egyptian government under Sisi really cracked down on any violence directed against the government, but not so against the Christians. So he was very concerned about it, and I think his fears were realized. This strike today was at the heart of the Coptic Church. This is the seat of power. This is Tawadros's home seat.
Lieutenant Colonel Rick Francona, thank you so much for giving us perspective on these two attacks.